from around the globe. It's theCUBE with digital coverage of AWS reInvent 2020. Sponsored by Intel and AWS.
We continue our coverage here in theCUBE of AWS reInvent 2020, and we're now joined by Guru Vasudeva, who is the Chief Technology Officer at Nationwide Insurance. And Guru, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us here on theCUBE.
Good afternoon,
Tom. Yeah, big announcement for you folks in terms of AWS and making that connection that you have even deeper and even broader, going with AWS now as your preferred cloud provider. Let's just talk about making that kind of a commitment. First off, on your end, what were some of those key factors, those drivers that led you to say, okay, this is where we really want to sink our resources?
Yeah, you know, our journey with this started almost 2 years ago. And what we were looking for was a partner who is leading edge in the cloud capabilities, as well as the ones that are creating new services. And obviously, AWS is definitely a great partner to do that. And then we also found that they have this AWS Next program, Enterprise Next program. So we found that to be pretty attractive as well, because it's not just about migrating the applications, but also modernizing them, innovating. So they were going to really give us not only the technical capability, but also access to talent and best practices. So we really entered into this partnership with the AWS to achieve all of the above.
Yeah, there's this, as you know, that it's very popular or in vogue, obviously, to talk about digital transformations, right? Yeah. Everyone's undergoing that, and is complete metamorphosis of your IT structure. But this is where you are, and you were already kind of in the throes of this, or in the midst of this, in terms of accelerating that process and refining that process. What is AWS now bringing to your table? And what did you want? What did you need from them to get you going a little bit quicker, maybe in the direction you were already going?
Yeah. You know, one of the, I will give you two answers. One, on the technology side, they've got a huge array of services available in AI, machine learning, data and analytics. So they're constantly innovating those things. So it makes it easier for us to really stitch together solutions that gives a better experience for our customers or for our agents or our financial advisors, right? On the process side, what they really brought to bear is their own internal methodology for innovation. So we've been able to really partner with our business partners and AWS to apply that methodology to really see, can we really do those kinds of things in an insurance company, right? Mm-hmm. And we have found that methodology to be of equal value.
You know, I mean, the fact is your portfolio is so broad, or you know, your arsenal, if you will, 2,000 plus applications, right? You got up and running, and you're moving a little less than half of them into AWS. I mean, this is a huge undertaking, and the idea obviously to maintain business operations as usual. So talk about that tightrope act. I mean, how do you manage that and keep business going, keep operations still humming? And in fact, you're already looking for new kind of efficiencies and new processes that make you even a little sharper, a little leaner.
Yeah, you know, the approach that we took is, it's a methodology that I've used with many of our transformations that I've had the opportunity to lead here at Nationwide, where we use a very methodical, repeatable process. And we call it, we started with diagnostics. And then once you do the diagnostics, you build a plan, and then you execute the plan, and then you go back and see, did it really give you the results, and tweak the loop, right? So our diagnostics methodology starts with looking at an existing application, for example, our claim system, or our policy admin system, right? These are very critical systems for a company like us. And you cannot just, you know, migrate them and hope that it'll work out, right? So instead, we did a very methodical approach of diagnosing and saying, technologically, architecture-wise, what needs to change? What are the opportunities for optimizing them instead of just migrating them likewise as is? Can we really optimize it and migrate it at the same time? How about security? What are the different things that we need to do on security wise, right? And then last but not least is money, right? What does it cost for us on-prem? And can it cost cheaper? And if we were to really apply all of these different levers, can we make it cheaper in the cloud? So we did all of those four different elements, and we found that methodology to be instrumental in our success story. This year, we migrated our claim system. We migrated our commercial lines policy admin system, our personal lines policy admin system, our nationwide.com, and all of our financial services front ends. So it's a huge, like it's like the heart and soul of the company. Mm-hmm. And they have gone extremely well. And we really attribute that to the methodical approach of looking at all these dimensions.
I don't know how you slept. that's a full slate. And to go back to the four points you were talking about earlier about the gains that you got. The last one that caught my attention there was about the bottom line, the fact that you reduced costs, that you did save money. So it is possible that this cloud migration, again, this is overarching level. Yeah. You can make this migration and go through this enormous transformation and still cut
save
your
money.
Yeah, add to the bottom line.
Yeah. So the many people these days, you read in the articles, oh well, cloud migration not necessarily saves you money, or that's not the real reason to do it. I didn't really want to accept that as an answer. Instead, what we really said is we want it to be better, faster, cheaper, all of the above, right? So we challenged ourselves to say, what would it cost if we were to really keep it on-prem? And what changes we need to make in order to get the efficiency? For example, our claim system, if we were to migrate it like for like, it would have cost us 25% more to run in the cloud. Hmm. We said, no, we're gonna tweak how we have architected, how much storage we need, what kind of things we provision. So we changed the architecture and the underpinning and the engineering, and we were able to find around 20% savings, right? Wow. So if you think about it, that's like a 45% swing. If we had not done the diagnostics after the migration, I would have been like, oh my God, it actually cost us more money, and that we couldn't really do.
You know, what's been the big gain in terms of, you talked about claims, so obviously heart and soul of your company, insurance policies, both on the commercial and the residential side, or the personal user. What's been the biggest impact, if you will, in terms of your core business and then introducing these new technologies and these new efficiencies into the process?
You know, this year for us, if you take a look at property and casualty companies like insurance companies, it's been a very eventful year, not only with COVID, but also with all the weather events that happened with the fires and the various tornadoes and so on. So when we have more claim volume, we can actually take our environment up and down seamlessly, right? We can add more capacity very seamlessly. So that's a base premise, if you will, off of the cloud, is that you can actually consume more and you don't have to really wait for adding additional capacity. That part has actually worked out really well. And the reverse is true as well. We've been able to actually reduce capacity when we don't need it, right? That's on the base level. And on the more innovation level, we've been able to tap into AI, machine learning kind of capabilities and stitch together new experiences in our commercial line space to deliver new types of insights, new types of solutions for our business partners. So we have been very pleased with how we've been able to stitch together solutions by kind of tapping into the various services that AWS provides.
Yeah, you've been talking about all these tremendous innovations in terms of how you go about your business and how you do your business. And certainly you're realizing great benefit and gain from that. What about the other side, your customers, millions of customers that you have, and as you said, experiencing a number of challenges this year, to say the least. But at the end of the day, what has been the bottom line, or what is going to be the bottom line for them?
For them, our kind of vision is completely transforming the customer experience that we provide them by digital capabilities, right? So they should be able to get to any answer they want, whether it's beyond their cell phone or their computer. And to do that, to provide that kind of service, I think these kind of technologies actually enables us to really deliver that kind of a digital transformation.
What about the security side of all this? I know that's part of your concern too. I mean, it's certainly an area that is receiving and understandably a lot of attention these days in terms of providing more secure solutions and making sure that this customer data, which is so precious, is protected. In terms of all this activity that you're doing, you've got to put in that layer of security on top of that, right? Which is paramount to your success these days as a company. What kind of focus have you maybe reconfigured in that respect now with regard to security and your customers and your operational security too?
Yeah. So, you know, in the diagnostics methodology that I talked about, security is one of those dimensions that we looked at. How do we secure the information on-prem versus in the cloud? They're not like for like. We need to apply different techniques, sometimes different technology. So we built that in from the beginning. And then the great thing is, you know, we have also learned a lot by working with Amazon about how do they do it in-house, right? I mean, they obviously run the biggest, if you will, online shopping capability out there. And how do they do it? So that's the other kind of access to talent that's been really helpful. And we look at this constantly. It's something that's evolving as new threat actors come on board or new techniques of attack comes on board. Mm-hmm. We're constantly evaluating and making sure that we are fine-tuning that security, whether it's on-prem or in the cloud.
Well, what are your headlights hitting now when you look down the road? I know you're not done with this by any means. I certainly understand that. But in terms of the next 12 to 18 months, what kind of progress do you want to make, and where do you think that you're gonna have to, where you want to make it the most?
So on the efficiency side, we've got a pretty big goal to reduce our expenses by hundreds of millions of dollars. We spend well over $1 billion on technology every year, and our cloud migration and optimization is definitely a key lever that we are pulling. And so for me, we have a target of applications that we wanted to want to migrate to the cloud. And we will be done with around 32% of them by the end of this year, another 30 to 32% next year. So we've got ways to go, but in the next couple of years, we would be well overweight really migrating what do we want to migrate to the cloud. So that's definitely a big focus area while delivering savings. On the innovation.
Excuse me, go ahead, please, go ahead.
Yeah. On the innovation side, I think there is so much more to be done, whether it be Internet of Things or providing new offerings for our customer, for our agents, for financial advisors. So there are so many new things that we can do. And now that we've got a repeatable pattern for migration, our energy is going to really shift towards those more innovation, more new and digital experiences. That's where our energy is going to really shift.
We took a big step today, certainly with the announcement. I know the AWS partnership is one that you put a lot of value on. It certainly has been successful for you, and we wish you all the continued success as well as you head on into 2021. But thank you for joining us here today.
Thanks, John.